to welcome Neha to the stage. So Neha, she's the founder and CEO at Obsess. She is reinventing the e-commerce interface for discovery-driven product categories. Her mission is really to turn online shopping into an experience, and then replace that monotonous grid of e-com's interface that hasn't changed since Amazon created it 25 years ago to sell books. Obsess is an augmented and virtual reality software platform for experiential shopping via a 3D commerce cloud. Before Obsess, Neha led engineering and product teams at Google, Vogue, a luxury e-commerce startup, and built platforms and products reaching millions of users. She's got a graduate degree in computer science from MIT. Neha, I'll let you take it away.
Hey, thank you, Abby. Thanks so much for having me. Super excited to be here and chat with all of you about shopping in the metaverse. I am sure it's a term that you have all heard lately. So I'm going to talk a little bit about experiential e-commerce, what that means, and what our platform Obsess like does in the space. So to begin with, if you think about any online shopping site today, right, it typically looks something like this. It's basically a grid of thumbnails on a white background, right? And whether you're shopping for fashion or luxury or really any category, it is the exact same interface as shopping for toothpaste on Amazon, because this interface was really created by Amazon 25 years ago to sell books, and then somehow it just, you know, got used for every category and by every brand. But today, 70% of US population identifies themselves as gamers, 90% of Gen Z, and we are also used to visual content in most of our other digital activities, including gaming and social media. But e-commerce has, you know, sort of lagged behind in that experience, and now it's catching up. And so experiential is coming to e-commerce. And what that means is like transforming this database like interface into something that's really visual and creative, contextual, like the products we are buying are visual, so it makes sense that you would experience them in a visual environment that can actually be custom designed for every brand and every category instead of, you know, all websites essentially looking the same. So for Obsess, we do this in the form of virtual stores, which are 3D 360 experiences that can live on a brand's website. So you don't have to download an app. You can also experience these in headsets, but it's not required. You can actually, 80% of our users are on mobile. So it's all optimized for mobile, also works great on desktop. And essentially, brands are able to create these CGI environments using assets that they already have, either in the form of 2D product images or 3D models of products, which more and more brands are starting to have now, thanks to Klo, which is great. And they can also use campaign assets that they produce, like images, videos, etc., lookbook images, and put that all together into a cohesive experience that's much more fun as a consumer for us to discover, to learn about the brand, to learn about products, and making the entire experience much more visual, interactive, and discovery-driven, and really distinguish from one brand to the other. Just like when you go to a real store, the experience is different for different brands. And they don't even have to be restricted to creating, you know, trying to recreate a retail store, because this is all virtual. They can make anything that they want, and brands can get really creative and create conceptual environments. For Obsess, we have created about 100 virtual stores. We work with some of the largest global luxury brands, premium fashion brands, and also like beauty and other categories. But here I put kind of more on the fashion side. And this is just to show that this technology is becoming quite common now. Some of the brands that you traditionally might think of as very traditional and slow moving have also adopted this technology, because it's just a more natural fit for the brand and for the products that they are selling. And ultimately, for the adoption of any new technology by brands and retailers, they have to see results in the form of KPIs. So our customers, you know, they have seen up to 10x higher traffic to their virtual stores compared to their physical stores, or up to 70% higher purchase conversion from the virtual store compared to their regular e-commerce flow, or up to 20% higher cart size. So, what I'm going to talk about next is how experiential e-commerce actually brings a lot of different technologies together, and what are some of those kind of various things that it actually comprises of beyond, the 3D virtual environment. So the first and most important is e-commerce integration. In the earlier days, a lot of brands used to kind of create these experiences as just one-off, like marketing sort of gimmicks. But ultimately, for this technology to become really adopted on a permanent basis, it has to drive sales and it has to integrate with e-commerce. So from these virtual stores, you're able to, they pull the entire product data, we integrate with inventory feeds. You can add to cart from within the virtual experience. So it's really a fully contained shopping experience versus just something where you, might discover and then you have to go through the regular kind of e-commerce site to actually purchase. The next point is embedded media. So what we see from our data is that the more content and media there is in the virtual experiences, the longer customers stay, the more they end up shopping. So this is something we encourage all of our customers to do. Like, yes, there are going to be a lot of products in the virtual stores, but adding in media and, again, assets that they already might be producing for other channels, but integrating them into their virtual environments helps with the performance. We also have avatars. I will let this video play.
Darlings, this is so exciting. Welcome to my virtual gift shop. In this amazing, beautiful gifting wonderland, here we are together
So
in virtual
that
reality.
is Charlotte Tilbury. She is in the Charlotte Tilbury virtual store. For us, like as much as the experiences are all virtual, one of our core principles is to bring the human touch into the online shopping experience. And that is actually derived from data again, because we see very high engagement from consumers on anything human within the experience. So people like really click on Charlotte Tilbury's avatar. They want to hear her speak. She's in every room of the virtual store, guiding people through the experience. Of course, these experiences don't have to be static because this is all CGI. We can create fun animations. We can change the store over time from one season to the next with that as well. And then what's super interesting is that now brands are starting to hold virtual events in virtual spaces. So we can live stream from a real place into a virtual store, and you can watch the live stream and then also be like shop right after that or shop from the live stream. Augmented reality try-on is much more prevalent in beauty today and has become kind of a standard part, but also starting in fashion too. So that can be integrated into the virtual experiences. You discover the product and then you can essentially try it on. And then back to the human touch, like you can ask questions to sales associates while you're in a virtual store, just like you would in a real store, and that technology is seamlessly integrated into your virtual experience as well. And then finally, in real life, we go shopping with our friends. This behavior has not really translated to e-commerce so far. So recently we released this feature that lets you actually go shopping in virtual stores with your friends. You can be on a video chat together. You don't even have to create an account or sign in or anything. It's just a unique link that you get, and your friends can kind of join the experience with you, and you can see where they are and jump to any section or any room of the store, which is super cool and is doing really well. And yeah, lastly, the future of experiential e-commerce. So I don't have nice videos and images for each of these points because this is the future and we don't have it yet. But what you're going to see in this space is like these experiences are going to become more and more dynamic. So, today, like we can do little animations, but we are restricted by the GPU on the mobile devices because all of this is being delivered through the browser. Over time, as GPUs become more powerful, the experiences will become more dynamic. They will become more personalized. We can then render dynamically for different users. And if Abby and I are going to the same store, we could maybe see different products, in the front shelf, which are recommendations for us. The creation of these experiences will become easier and easier. Today, you have to have knowledge of like 3D softwares and 3D programs to create these environments. But over time, tools will be built that even if you don't have a lot of 3D knowledge, it'll be super easy to create these experiences. And then finally, Today, a lot of these experiences live on the brand's websites, but what we are also gonna, we have started already seeing this a little bit this year, and definitely we'll be seeing more of it next year, is brands releasing virtual stores on different metaverse platforms, which today are mostly gaming platforms like Roblox and Fortnite, as they have the largest audiences. But over time, I think there will be new metaverse platforms that won't start out as games, but that will be actually purpose-built, maybe for shopping or fashion and for various other activities. And you will see presence from brands in all of these different environments. Great. And to end with my ask, we are hiring 3D engineers and product managers. So if you are one of these, or if you know anyone who might be interested in what we're doing, please feel free to reach out to me. Thank you so much for having me.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Neha.